All right, everybody, welcome back to another one of my Verbling classes. This hour we are going to be going over reading and pronunciation. While reading through a short story, the short story is called Hide and Seek, and it is located at this website. I'll go ahead and put this in the chat box. Yay, my Verbling chat's working. All right, very cool. All right, so that's the short story that we're going to be reading. It's called Hide and Seek. Hey, Jocelyn, how you doing, man? I'll go ahead and put this in my Google chat as well. All right, and I do have an announcement to make tomorrow. Tomorrow I'll be giving 3 classes, separated by maybe between about 1 and 2 hours. So three classes during the day tomorrow. I'll be talking about the ED endings. Okay, so this is going to be pronunciations. So if you are interested in learning how we pronounce our ED endings, come check out this class. We'll be going over the rules. I'll be giving you a sheet that goes over those rules as well. And then I found a website that has like 4,000 words that all end in ED. All right, so we're obviously not going to get through them all, but we're gonna practice those ED endings until you know exactly how we pronounce those, and that you'll have that sheet, and I want you to keep that sheet with you so that you can practice that and have it as a reference. But this hour we are going to be practicing our pronunciation as well as reading. It's more going to be pronunciation. I really like that's going to be tomorrow. If you look at my schedule, I have the 3 classes. They're going to be in my time morning, so maybe starting about right now, and then. Or no, the hour before. So an hour before now and tomorrow, and then 2 more hours during the day. So I'm going to be giving the same class. Just in case if you miss one, you can make it to the other one. Or if you want to get more practice, you can go to that class as well. All right. So that's when we're going to be doing that ED endings. All right. So here in this class, we are going to be talking about pronunciation and practicing our pronunciation as we read through a short story. But first, let's see who we got today. We've got Anastasia. How are you?
I'm fine, and you?
I'm doing really good. And do you have anything new you want to share? Is everything going well?
Yeah, actually, I was on Spanish class before, maybe 2 hours. Class with Paulino, beginner class Spanish, and cool. I'm so excited about this one. I even don't know the alphabet, Spanish alphabet, but I know to ask how are you, where you're from, what is your mother's name, basic, but still
awesome.
Happy about this one stuff. And well, I did my exercises today for 1 hour. How about you?
Well, obviously I practice my Spanish every day with my family. This morning was my off day, because I do, my exercises are really intense, and so I have to let my body heal.
Yeah.
So right now I can barely lift my arms up because I did the equivalent of about, let's see. So I did about 70 pull-ups. Okay.
Wow.
Both front ways this way, as well as so arms wide and then arms together. I did 70 pull-ups, 35 of each, and then a different variation of it where I actually was pulling weights down into my body and then weights down this way. And so it really it's funny. It's like these little muscles in the back of my shoulders, they're killing me right now. And then on the same day, I started mixing it up. So I'm doing my back and then my triceps, and so in the back of my arms. And because I read something about not working too many muscle groups in the same area.
So
like a bigger muscle group, like your back and then triceps, your chest, and then the biceps. So anyway, I started doing that, and I am in pain. I really am in pain.
Yeah, I kind of understand you, because like yesterday I do like two workouts. One in the morning, I was playing tennis. I mean, like training.
Yeah.
And my muscles also just from.
Oh yeah.
Triceps are also. My muscles are sore. Yes, very. And then in the evening, I do 1 hour for stretching my muscle. You know.
Oh, okay. Cause, cool.
Yeah, because like they. Just not need to be short, you know. When you just do weights, your muscle get shorter. So you need lean and just stretch them.
Stretch them out. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Usually you should do it once a week, 1 hour for stretch.
Yeah. Usually before I exercise and after I exercise, I do stretching. To make sure that I don't pull any muscles or anything like that. So.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's been a good week so far. Tomorrow I'm going to be doing my lower body, so my legs, and then my shoulders. So it'll be the front side of my shoulders. So it should be a good workout. Well,
yeah.
Very cool. Welcome, welcome back to class. Okay, Anastasia.
Yeah. Thanks.
Yeah, and Arkady, how you doing, man?
I'm fine, Chad. Sorry, I had connection problems in your last lesson, so I disconnected.
I thought for sure Arkady's just, he's pissed off, he hates me, and I was crying, and I didn't know what to do. Alright, cool, man. Welcome back. It's good to have you here, man.
Thank you, Chad.
Let's see. We also have Dimitri. Now, these are the two guys that I get mixed up every once in a while. So I've got Arkady and I have Dimitri. Okay. Now Arkady is from Russia. I know that. Whenever I see your name, I was like, okay, yes, Russia. But you guys look very similar. Not totally similar. So when you guys come into class, I'm like, uh oh. All right. And it usually happens with Dimitri. I'm like, oh man. Is this the guy from Russia or is this the guy from Ukraine? But now I have you both in the same class, and I know. All right, cool. Very cool. How you doing, Dimitri?
I'm pretty good, thank you. And how are you on today?
I'm doing really well. Thank you for asking. What's going on? What's new? Anything exciting happening today?
Everything is quiet. Nothing interesting. I had been on my work today, and now I am at home.
Ah, okay. All right. Very cool. And did you switch over to start doing English classes for children yet, or were you working in as the chess tutor today?
I was working as a chess tutor today, but I'm gonna to be English tutor maybe next year in autumn.
Okay. Cool, man. That should be awesome. You got to let me know how it goes, because I'm planning on being at Verbling forever. I love Verbling. I was working at another website, and I just quit that website. I was like, Verbling is so much better. And so I'm going to start doing
Spanish classes. Spanish classes. Please, Chad. Yes, for beginners.
I may do that. We'll see what happens. So I'm now going to be teaching. It's probably going to be about 50 or so hours a week here, doing about 15 to 20 hours at night or my nighttime, which would probably be morning for you guys. So about 15 to 20 hours a week at night, and then my usual daytime hours that I do now. So I'm pretty excited about it. Cool. Welcome. Welcome back to class. It's good to see you again, Dimitri.
Okay, but I want to ask you, what is the use for Verblin to pay you money as a teacher? Who pays you for your work, if it is not secret?
Verblin pays me.
But I don't understand. What is the use if many people come free for Verblin? So maybe.
Verbling will become a paying website.
Yeah, they've already started into having some people start paying if you want to. I imagine some of their revenue also comes from the amount of users that they have, and any advertisements that they may be able to hand out that way. The other thing maybe Facebook or YouTube or things like that. There's many ways to get income online, and I'm sure people who are much smarter than I am are figuring that out, and I'm happy as long as they keep paying me so I can keep doing the job. I'm okay, you know. So yeah, I'm pretty happy about that. No, Verbling really is a good site. The one thing that I enjoy most about this is, yes, you can do a lot of things for free, and when they pair you up. So one side of Verbling is also what you guys are doing, so taking lessons, right? The other side of Verbling is speaking with an actual native speaker from whatever country or language you're looking to you're looking to learn or practice, and that's the real advantage with Verbling. Some sites only focus on one language, and that's it, and that's okay, you know. But what I really enjoyed about Verbling is that it kind of opens this whole spectrum of different languages from all over the world. And then for me, as well as a English teacher, before I was only teaching Spanish speakers and Portuguese speakers, which is fine. I have nothing against them. I love teaching English just in general. Really, the fact of the matter is, I love meeting people and helping people as much as I can. The benefit to that is that, yes, I do get paid. So here I get to meet people from all over the world, and it's awesome. I love it. I think it's really cool. So that's why I really enjoyed Verbling. Yes, Verbling does have its issues every now and then with Hangouts and things like that, but it's technology, and you'll always have something that's some sort of bug to work through. But anyway, I'll quit talking, and I want to get through meeting everybody. Let's see. We have Ezra. How are you doing, Ezra?
Hello, Chad. I'm very well. How are you?
I'm doing great. Now, I remember last time we spoke about this picture, and this is a picture of Central Park. But you're not living there. You are living in...
Turkey.
Ah, okay. I see. I was going to say Egypt, but okay, you're in Turkey. Now, Ezra, let's see. Remind me what you do, Ezra. What do you do?
I'm an English teacher. I work as an English teacher in a private school.
Uh-huh.
A secondary and high school teacher.
Well, when is it?
Okay, awesome. So English teacher in a private school, secondary. Okay,
yeah.
Very cool. I'm going to keep working on this, okay, Ezra? So Ezra from Turkey. Okay, good. All right, excellent. Welcome back to class. And we have Inga. Inga, how you doing?
Hi, Chad. I'm good, thanks. What about
all
you?
Right. I'm doing really good. Now, Inga, I would always get mixed up for such a long time until she finally got mad. Inga sent me the meanest email, you guys, the meanest email. She said, Chad, if you forget my... No, I'm just messing. Inga's a very nice person, everybody. She's a very nice person. But I did. It is the truth. I kept forgetting where Inga was from. Now... Because every time you come in, I see your name and I think Albany, and I'm like, no, she's not from Albania. Okay, she knows Russian and she knows Armenia and Armenian, and so that's how I remember. So she's Armenian, but she knows both of the languages, and she works in a bank, and she works in risk management. And I think I will remember that until the day that I die. Just like I remember my first telephone number that I ever had in my whole entire life, I will never forget my telephone number. Very good. So how you doing, Inga? Good to have you here.
Thanks. I'm doing well. I'm very happy that I can join your class today, because it seems I missed some classes.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did. But that's okay. We all have lives and we have things we need to get to. And sometimes as well, other teachers have really good classes that are going on at the same time that that I do. And it's okay to go visit other teachers. All right. They all have different teaching styles and things like that. But I did want to mention once again, tomorrow is going to be the ED spree. Okay, I'm doing three classes of ED endings. All right, so if you want to practice those endings, come and join me tomorrow. All right, let's go to Manal. Manal, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing good. And Manal, she doesn't like to talk about her job, which means that she's either an assassin or she actually is a fighter. So she fights people. And I'm just kidding with you, Manal.
Yeah, I want to kill you.
That's awesome. Very good, very good. And so, Manal, tell me something new. What's going on?
Nothing.
Nothing
happened. Yeah, before 1 hour, you know.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. And so, let's see. Hopefully tomorrow you'll get a good story for me, and you'll be able to share something, and we'll be able to have a good laugh.
Yeah, hopefully.
All right. Welcome back to class, Manal. And this guy right here, I'll never forget either. I think he was in one of my first classes, and I was like, Moonwalker? What kind of a name is Moonwalker? He's like, it's really not Moonwalker, it's Roberto, and I'm from Italy.
Yes.
How you doing, Roberto? It's been a while.
Very, very good. And you?
I'm doing really good. So tell me, what's new, Roberto? Anything new going on in your life?
Not so much. I'm working hard.
Good.
For an international conference on 4th May. So I need to practice my English.
Okay, good. Well this is definitely the place to do so.
Yeah.
All right, man. Welcome back. Good to see you again. All right. And Naresh, how you doing?
I'm doing good. What about
Excellent.
You?
I'm doing really good. Now, if I remember correctly, Naresh, you are from India and you work in computer networking. Is that right?
Correct, yeah.
Excellent. How's your day going for you?
It was normal day. And today there was a lot of work in office, so I came late today. Otherwise, it was routine.
Okay. Now, do you go to different sites and work on their networks there, or do you are you now working mainly from an office and trying to troubleshoot from there?
No, I sit at office only, and from there I design customers network, multiple customers network, and also troubleshoot the customers network from there only. I don't go to multiple office. I handle everything from there.
All right. So so you design there in your office, and then from there you send other people out to actually install and connect all the wires up and things like that, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. Very cool. Very cool. Awesome. Welcome back to class, Naresh.
Thank you.
Let's see. We've got Yasin as well. How you doing, Yasin?
Thank you, Teacher Chet. I'm fine. And you?
I'm doing great. Now, Yasin is from Turkey as well, yes. Just like Ezra. Ezra, who's an English teacher, but her picture is from Central Park. All right, I'm working on my memory here. All right, so Yasin, it's funny because I think I've asked you Yasin like three times now because Yasin is a lecturer, and he lectures about computer programming and things like that.
Yeah.
And I think every time I ask you, I say, so Yasin, what do you like to do in your free time? And you go, computer programming.
Exactly.
it's funny, and so I started remembering that, and I was like, yeah, it's just funny how people can enjoy something so much that I mean, your work is also your hobby, and your hobby is also your work, and so you actually enjoy life a little bit more like that, right?
And my another hobby is follow to verbling.com.
That's right. Come to verbling.com and practice English. All right. Cool. All right, everybody. Any questions for me before we get started? Not so much? Okay, let's go ahead and do this thing. We are going to be reading this, reading through this short story and practicing our pronunciations. I have no clue what this story is about. I just like the size of the paragraphs that they had here, and I was like, "Yeah, these look good. We should be able to get some good practice." This shouldn't be a highly complex story, so we're not going to be using extremely advanced words or anything like that. From when I searched it, I was looking for words. For a short story that would be good for a teenager to read. So not words at a college level or anything like that. Just basic everyday speaking, easy to read, and we'll practice our reading that way. Okay. So go ahead and open up this page. Okay. This short story is called Hide and Seek.
Short.
Right? And. It is short, but also long. It scrolls down a ways. Okay, so let's go ahead and we'll start off with this first paragraph. And I'm going to start off on the right hand side this hour. And Yasin, let me have you read that first paragraph, please.
Okay, teacher. Many could see the welcoming doorway ahead. Its dark corners invited her seductively, and she pushed her waning legs even harder. The small rucksack on her back thudded against her with every step, the tin box inside painfully jobbing into her shoulder. The bag was wet and heavy, but very necessary. Behind her, she could hear Billy puffing frack. Tikali. He seemed further away than ever now. The pouring rain had slowed their progress, but somehow it also offered them protection, like a shield covering their elusive movements.
Okay, good. That would be elusive movements.
Elusive movements.
Okay, I've got about six words here I want to practice with you. Some of these words you have probably never seen before, which is just fine. Okay, the first word is going to be seductively. Okay, I'm going to write that here in the chat box. Seductively. Try that, please.
Seductively.
Okay, very good. All right, our next word is an ED ending word. Okay, it ends in an SH. Okay, so yes, pushed. Okay, so that ED is going to sound like a T, pushed.
Pushed.
Okay. Now I want to practice this A sound, how we say ja. Okay, this is more like an ah. Okay, it's jabbing.
Jabbing.
Okay. Good. One more time. Ja. Jabbing.
Jabbing.
Good. Much better. Yeah. Sometimes those who are learning English tend to say jobbing and use more of an ah sound, okay? But you want to stay away from that in most cases with that A and use an ah sound, jabbing, okay? Mm-hmm. The next word is going to be heavy, okay? Here the E is going to get the is going to receive the action. What I mean by that is that A, we're going to act like it's not there. Okay, and this the E in this word is going to have a short E sound. That short E is eh. Okay, so the word is heh, heavy. Try that, heavy.
Heavy.
Good. All right. Now this word here has a short U sound in it. That short U is puh. Okay, it makes an U sound. Puffing. Good. All right. Our last word I want to practice is the word frantically.
Frantically.
Good. Frantically. Okay. Wow. And you see here that first A has that ah sound, frantically. Okay. And at the end, because of the A-L-L-Y ending, it's more of an ully, frantically. Okay. Frantically.
Frantically.
Okay. Good. Nice job. Okay, let's go to Anastasia. Okay, so I'm going to be going from the outsides down into the middle, okay?
Okay, gotcha.
Please read the next paragraph.
Okay. Reaching their way, Maddie felt against the door. Struggling for breath, breaths, she wiped away the rain from her face and smoothed her hair back. The solar rays of the dark but dry archway did nothing to ease her angst. She turned and beckoned Billy frantically. "Come on," she groaned, watching his little legs turning like a hamster in a wheel. She mocked at the spectacle before her. If it wasn't for him, this would be funny. Oops.
Okay, good. All right. So I've got four words I want to practice here. My first word is going to be a breath. Okay, so we're going to practice that TH ending. Yes, breath. One more time.
Breath. Breath.
Good. Breath. Good. All right. Now this next word here is going to be though. Okay. It starts off with a TH sound as well.
Though.
But the O U G H makes an O sound, right? And now here you are saying though, using more of a Z sound, okay?
Okay.
Now there's two different TH sounds. There's a voiced and an unvoiced, okay? Voiced would be breath. That's when we make that th sound, okay?
Uh-huh. Okay.
Now in this word, it's th, and it's more of a vibration. Th. Yeah. So we stick our tongue between our teeth and we make that th sound. More, it sounds sort of like a Z, but we have our tongue there. And we say, though. Try that.
No. No.
Good. All right, Nadesh, I'm gonna mute your microphone just until it's your turn, okay? There we go. So one more time. Though.
Though.
Perfect. That was really good, okay? My next word is going to be groaned.
Groaned.
Okay? This is going to have a D ending. So instead of ending it with a T and saying groaned, okay, we're going to say groaned.
Groaned. Groaned.
Okay, one more time, all right? So right now, what you're doing is you're saying groaned, all right, and pronouncing that more like a T. So let's say your teeth are here, your tongue is kind of curving up right before your teeth, and your teeth are coming closer together. That's how you're pronouncing that T sound, groaned. All right, so what you want to do is, let's say this is the top of your mouth, you want to pull your tongue back just a little bit so your tongue can hit the top of your mouth. All
okay.
right, and you can say groaned.
Groaned.
Okay.
Groaned.
Oh, that's it. One more time, groaned.
Groaned.
There, groaned. There you go.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's groaned. That D sound.
Yeah.
Groaned.
Uh-huh. Groaned.
Good. Nice job. Good. Okay, last word. Now, this is going to have a T sound here, okay? The word is mocked, okay? Now, I believe you pronounced your ED correctly, but that O, that O in the word is going to sound like an ah sound, okay? So, we're going to say mocked.
Mocked.
Good. Mocked.
Mocked.
Excellent. Nice job.
Uh-huh.
Okay, good. Thank you. Let's go to Naresh. Let me have you read the next paragraph, please, starting off with boots. Nadesh, make sure to unmute your microphone. And read that next paragraph. It starts with the words, with boots weighed down. You see that?
Yeah. I got
okay,
it.
Okay, go for it.
With boots weighed down by mud, Billy ignored the pain in his legs and trudged on. Mom would kill me if she could see me on legs. Oh, how she hated dirty children. He could see his sister ahead and longed to be near her again. At 7, Billy was tall for his age, but his face hid his age well. He had a baby face and was often tested as teased at school. His big sister looked after him. She always knew what to do. She didn't let them get away with it. And once again, he was running to her. Gosh, that was tough. He croaked as he fell against the door. Come on. we had to hide in here, here, in the church, believe impaired. Unless you want to wait here to be found, she quipped abruptly and pushed the door with all she had. Shaking his head, he followed her obediently, knowing that was not an option.
Okay, good. Good. Nice job, Naresh. Let's practice your R sound, okay?
Okay.
Now, I know this. The R sound can be difficult for those that are from India and Pakistan, okay? because mainly when you are speaking, you hold your tongue back further in your mouth. So let's say this is the top of your mouth, and you know how there's that curve that kind of goes up. Okay, so your teeth would be right here, and you have that flat part and then the curve. So your tongue kind of sits right back here. And so when you're speaking, most everything happens further back, okay? And then so the sounds come from here, but the actions are happening at the front of your mouth, okay? So what we want to do is we kind of want to loosen your mouth up a little bit, because in English, the sounds are going to happen as well in the front and in the back, but you're going to use your tongue a lot more, and you're going to curve your tongue down, all right, and you're going to flatten it against the top of your mouth and things like that, okay? Right now, your tongue is sort of staying flat, and you're vibrating it. And for example, when you say the word her, you said her, okay, and you're vibrating it here. So instead of saying her and vibrating that R, you want to push your tongue down and kind of have it arced like this. So we're going to say her. Try that. Her.
Her.
Okay. So force your tongue down. Okay. Force your tongue down. You want to push it so it doesn't vibrate against the top of your mouth. Try that one more time. Her.
Her.
Good. Her. There you go. There you go. Okay. See? Now you can control it so it doesn't vibrate. All right. Now we're going to practice another word. We're going to practice the word after. Okay, so we're going to practice that af, and then going from that tr into that er sound. Okay, so we're going to say after.
After.
Good, good. Okay, so you kind of have to force yourself and push your tongue down and say, no, I don't want you to do that, all right? So you're right now you're having a battle. Your brain is thinking and trying to control your tongue, all right? And that's what's going to happen. But as you do this, okay, at first you're going to be really tired because you're going to have to focus on that a lot, all right? But yeah, after you do this, when you speak English, your R's are going to become awesome, and you're going to be able to speak with a better English accent, okay? So one more time, we're going to try after her. Try that.
After her.
Good. Okay, the next word I want to practice is the word here. Here.
Here.
Good. Okay, one more time. And we're going to say more of an ear. Here. Here.
Ear.
Okay.
Here.
There you go. Pronounce that H. Here.
Here. Here.
Good. Nice job. Okay. All right. Now for the complicated one. All right. You ready for this? Okay. This word is tr. Okay. So we're going to start off with a TR sound. We're going to say trudged.
Trudged.
Okay, trudged. So instead of saying, right now you're saying trudged. Okay, open up your mouth just a little bit. We want to say trudged.
Trudged. Trudged.
Okay, so trudged. Let's practice one sound, okay? I want you to say tr. Okay, just that sound. Tr.
Tr.
Okay, one more time. Tr. Tr.
Tr. Tr.
Okay. Getting closer, getting closer. Okay, sure, sure. So it's gonna almost start off with a ch sound. Okay, so we're gonna say trudged.
Trudged.
Okay, try and start off with that ch sound.
Trudged.
All right. Okay. So we found the word that is the trickiest for Naresh here. Okay. So what I want you to do is practice pronouncing words like trudged, track, trust, trample.
Trust.
Okay, so there's four words right there that you can practice that have that TR sound, and practice trying to push your tongue down and not having that hard R and saying tr, tr. Okay, so okay. Your jaw's kind of out with English. You don't want your jaw to come out to be able to pronounce that tr, tr. Okay, let it relax a little bit, and we're gonna say tr, trudge. Okay, it's more with your trudge. Lips and your tongue in there. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Yeah. Very good. But you did really well with the R on words like her, here, and after. Okay. Good job, okay. Man.
Thank you.
Let's go to Arkady. Let me have you read the next paragraph, please, starting at inside.
Okay. Inside, the vastness of the church surrounded them. Feeling very small, they purposefully made their way to the back, scanning the pews anxiously. He won't find us here, will he? Maybe look down at her inquiring brother. He looked tight, grabbing his hand protectively. She pulled him along quickly. No, he won't find us in here.
Good. Nice job. All right, let's practice the word very. Give me a good V sound there. Very.
Very.
Okay, let's practice that that phrase. Feeling very small.
Feeling very small.
Good, good. All right, our next word is the word purposefully.
Purposefully.
Good. One more time. Purposefully.
Purposefully.
Awesome. All right, and our last word is anxious. Or sorry, it's anxiously.
Anxiously. I don't know this word, so anxiously. What does it mean?
To be anxious is to worry. Be... Worry. Say that one more time.
Worry.
Yeah, you could be, but you're worried... you're worried in almost a good way. So, have you ever seen like kids when you're going to take them to the candy store or when you're going to take them to the movies? Like, oh, are we going to go yet? That would be like anxious. They're worried. They don't know if they're going to get there. Okay, and so they're anxious. They want it. Okay, so maybe like Christmas morning for those of you who celebrate Christmas, or Hanukkah or things like that, where you're going to be receiving presents, you're anxious and you can't wait until that day comes. Okay, so almost hyperactive, not so much. That would be a different thing, but you're really excited. And you can't wait for that, and it's that feeling of I just keep thinking of the word in Spanish, ansioso. I can't think of another word. Yeah, it's like it's anxious. So okay, so that's what that is. Okay, other than that, excellent job, Arkady. I could tell that you were focusing on that V sound, and you almost made it there, almost. But just remember. Remember, you want to put your teeth up on top of your lip and to pronounce that V sound, okay? And then anxiously, yeah, that X and I is going to make a sh sound, anxiously, okay? Other than that, very good job. Like pews sounded wonderful. Have you seen that word before, Arkady?
No, I think that it sounds like news, pews, so I said like this.
Good, exactly. Yeah, exactly right. And then inquiring sounded really good and protectively. Okay, good job. Nice reading.
Thank you, teacher.
All right, let's go to Roberto. Let me have you read the next paragraph, please.
Okay.
We're at Billy allowed himself, I believe.
Okay. Billy allowed himself to be led. They had played this game before, but never ended up in the church. He didn't like churches. They seemed so cold and quiet, but right now, this was a good place to be, away from him. At the back of the church, to the right of the altar, I don't know this word.
Altar.
Stood a tall, thin door. checking that no one was following them, Mehdi tried to try the handle. It was locked.
Okay, good job. All right, good job with your ED endings here. I do want to practice. First off is the word churches, okay,
churches.
With the ES ending, okay, churches.
Okay,
so that S at the end won't sound like an S. We won't say churches. We say churches with more of a Z sound, churches.
Churches.
Good, good, just like that. Okay, the next word I want to practice, where do we go? Okay, and you kind of switched off, Roberto. Sometimes your short I sound was awesome, and sometimes you use that Italian I, okay? for example, in the word this, okay, on that first sentence, you had said this.
You are right. You told me it in the first lesson, and I try to modify, but it's hard to change.
It is, and you're doing good, but it takes a lot of work and a lot of practice to get there. Yeah,
I have to remember. I have to remember it when I speak English.
Yes,
but thank
exactly.
You.
Okay. The next word is on the last line where it says. A handle, okay? We are going to pronounce that H. When you pronounce the word, you used a silent H and you said handle.
Okay.
Okay, that
handle.
Word is handle, okay? With that small H sound, it's like a breath. Handle.
Handle.
Good, good. Okay, other than that, your ED ending sounded wonderful, okay? Yeah. And these other words here, checking your CH sounds were really good, okay? One thing I'd like to point out.
Yeah.
Whenever you see like an IR ending or a UR ending or an AR ending, we are more often than not going to pronounce that like an ER ending. Okay. So on that word alter, okay, we wouldn't say altar, okay, giving that another sound. We would just cut right to an ER sound and say alter. Okay. So
alter.
that's just a trick that you would be able to use.
Okay. When I don't know a new, when I find a new word. Okay.
Yeah, sure. Okay, alter. Great job.
Okay, thank you.
All right, let's go to Dimitri. Let me have you read the next paragraph, please.
Okay. Outside in the distance, she could hear a booming voice. It carried across the wind like a vulture seeking its prey. Maddie Billy squeezed her hand even tighter. He is coming, Matt. She tried the door again. They had to find somewhere to hide, and quick, wrenching the handle with increasing agitation, it suddenly creaked and sprang open.
Good. Okay, so I've got two words that I want to practice with you. Okay, the first word is vulture.
Vulture.
Okay, so yeah, that T there is going to sound more like a CH. Okay, and that, like what I was explaining before, when you see like a U-R-E or I-R or A-R ending, we're usually going to pronounce that like a E-R. So that word is vulture, vulture, okay?
Vulture.
All right, the next word is going to be, where's my paragraph? Where'd you go? Okay, so, somewhere. Okay, so the word somewhere, the accent is going to go at the beginning of the word instead of at the end. You had said somewhere, okay? So somewhere is, you added the accent there. So we want to put it at the very beginning saying somewhere, somewhere.
Somewhere.
Okay,
somewhere.
Good. Let's throw that back into that sentence and practice that, okay? So we're going to say, they had to find somewhere to hide.
They had to find somewhere to hide.
Good, good. Last word is agitation.
Agitation.
On the last line, right after the word increasingly, the second word there, agitation.
Increasing agitation.
Increasing agitation. One more time, agitation.
Agitation.
Good, nice job. Okay, very good, Dimitri. All right, let's go to Manal. Let me have you read the next paragraph, please.
Okay, where is the beginning?
We are on the paragraph that says inside the room.
Okay,
there you go.
Okay. Inside the room was dusty and leak. Leak. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay. The solidarity window there did to. Oh my gosh! What's this word?
Illuminate.
Illuminate the shadows, but didn't. Instead, it fleetingly highlighted the contest of the room, testing them with heading places that were too small, too exposed, too obvious, maybe
scrunched.
Yeah, scrunched her eyes to focus. The Chad, why you always give me a hard one? Yeah.
That's gonna be the furniture.
Okay. Oh my gosh, I didn't. Okay. The furniture was not enough. They had to be cleverer than that.
Uh-huh.
Etchy was far too good at this game.
Okay, good. So he was far too good at that game. So let's do something else. Now that you've seen the words once before, and it does have a lot of harder words here. Let me have you read through the paragraph one more time, okay? And so you've seen them once before, and we'll try and go through it, okay, Mana?
Okay.
Read through that one more time.
Okay. Inside the room was dusty and bleak. The solitary window dared to illuminate the shadows, but didn't. Instead, it fleetingly highlighted two contents of the room, testing them with heading places that were too small, too exposed, too obvious. Maddie scratched her eyes to focus. The furniture was not enough. They had to be cleverer than that. Etchy was far too good at this game. Yay!
Okay. There you go. Good. Nice. Nice. All right, let's take a look at some of these words, okay? First off, the first word is solitary.
Solitary, yeah, okay.
Okay, solitary with the accent at the beginning. The next word is going to be illuminate. Try that. Illuminate.
Illuminate.
Excellent. Illuminate. Okay. All right. After that, we have the word contents.
Contents.
Mm-hmm, with the accent at the very beginning. Contents. Try that one more time.
Contents.
Good. Okay. The next word is going to be hiding. Now, this word you were pronouncing instead of with a long I sound, high, okay, you were saying
yeah.
Hey. It was more like a heh. Hiding. Okay, more of it like a hey into that. So just attack that and use that long I sound. High. Hiding.
Hiding.
Good. One more time. Hiding.
Hiding.
Good. Nice job.
Hiding.
Okay. This word here is cleverer.
What's that mean?
To be clever is to be witty. Okay.
Smart.
Smart. Yeah.
Smart.
To be smart.
Intelligent.
Be intelligent. Mm-hmm.
Oh my gosh. So it's clever. Oh my gosh. I didn't realize.
Yeah. Yeah, the word is.
Have you ever heard someone that tell you clever?
Oh my god, I don't know what's wrong.
There is a problem. I'm kidding.
So let's try that word one more time. The word is cleverer.
Oh my god, cleverer.
Good, cleverer. Okay, excellent. And yeah, that's all I had for you. Good job. Okay, so sometimes if we have words that are difficult, like fleeting, highlighted, okay, things like that. If we read back through it one more time, Okay, take a breath and go back through it. You'll be able to pronounce it a little bit better, all right? So you did good. Yeah. You did really good. Nice job. Okay, let's go to Emre. And your paragraph starts off with closing the door. Please read that.
Okay, closing the door behind her gently. Medis shuffled around the scattered obstacles, searching for the far corner of the room. It was darkest here, as she moved to the side to avoid a pile of books. Her foot bumped something hard and wooden. The sound reverberated around the room, and they stood deathly still as he heard.
Okay, just till there. Thank you. Actually, let me have you read this shorter paragraph as well. Go ahead and read that.
Again?
Yeah, please read this next paragraph as well, starting with the wind.
Okay. The wind outside had strengthened as it bettered. The windows and roof of the church almost as tall. The wind too was playing their game. Its whistling unnerved them, and they instinctively huddled closer.
Okay, good. All right, so in these two paragraphs, we have a ton of words that have ED endings, all right? Some of those you were really good on, others you were almost there, okay? So I want to go ahead and practice these, all right? Our first word is going to be shuffled. You see that? Shuffled.
Shuffled.
Excellent, all right? Our next word is going to be scattered.
Scattered.
Excellent, good job. Okay, after that we have moved. With a V and a D ending, moved.
Moved.
Good. Okay, now this is a long one. You probably haven't seen this word before. The word is reverberated. Reverberated.
Reverberated.
Okay, one more time. Reverberated.
Reverberated.
Excellent. Okay. This is a longer word as well. This is difficult because we have that G and that TH there, okay? The word is strengthened. Strengthened.
Strengthened.
Okay, strengthened. One more time. Strengthened.
Strengthened.
Excellent.
I can say TH sound.
Yeah, it's a hard one. It's a hard one. All right. This next word here is battered.
Chad, sorry. Battered. Excuse me. Can yes. you repeat strengthened?
Yes, it's strengthened.
Strength.
Okay, that has strengthened. It has a voiced TH there.
It's impossible.
Okay, strengthened. Who said it was impossible?
Me.
Who
said? Me.
You said that's Roberto. Impossible? It yeah. is not impossible.
It's impossible
actually,
for me.
Actually, I cannot pronounce this word too.
Okay. Strength. So this is okay, like, this is how you do it. Okay? So we're going to separate the word right there. Okay? We're going to say strength. Okay,
strength?
So don't think that
okay.
there's a G there. We're gonna go to a sort of like a K sound. Strength. Strengthen.
Okay.
Strengthen. Okay. Strengthen.
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 Good. Okay, strength.
Strengthen.
Good. All right, so we have strengthen. All right, put them strength. A little bit closer uh-huh. together. Strengthen. Strengthen.
Strengthen. Okay.
Strengthen.
All right, so wait a minute. Wasn't it that like maybe 30 seconds ago, someone in class was saying it's impossible to pronounce the word.
Okay, there okay. You go. Hey, because you are a good teacher.
No way. You're a good student. You're a good practicer.
Yeah, Chad, we are the good students, but you are not a good
that's what it is. That's what it is.
No,
okay.
No,
so. I know. So when you have words that are difficult to pronounce, split them apart, okay, mm-hmm. and focus on that sound. That's what I was trying to do with Naresh. Now his word trudged. That is a really difficult word. Okay, you have that TR sound, then the D into the G, and then an ED ending. Oh man, that's a nightmare. That's a nightmare. Okay, but. If you work on it little by little, you'll be able to pronounce the word, okay? Yeah. And if you break down the word strengthen, okay, and also me explaining that we don't actually pronounce that G, we pronounce that more like a K sound. Now, we do that because when we pronounce a K, okay, our tongue is already in this form, all right, and we're closing off that N, okay, strength. And by that, we can stick our tongue right through our teeth, okay? So we go like this, right through the teeth, and then back in. Strengthen, all right? And it's easier for us to say, okay? So when you break the words in. Exactly, that's it. Nice job. Okay, so I have, I think one more word or so to practice, and then we need to get to Inga before class ends, okay? So my last word that I wanted to practice with you, Emre, is unnerved. Unnerved.
Unnerved.
Good. Get that V sound in there. Unnerved.
Unnerved.
Good. Unnerved. Good. Unnerved.
Unnerved.
There nerved. You go. Nice job, man. Okay, cool. Let's go to Inga. Inga, let me have you read the next paragraph, please. Inga, can you hear me okay? Uh-oh, I put Inga to sleep. Oh, man, I taught another boring class.
I'm here. she wakes up.
All right. Okay, Inga, we are on the paragraph that says suddenly from nowhere.
Okay. Do you hear me now?
Yep, I hear you.
Okay. Suddenly from nowhere, a loud bang and intensified whistling shattered the silence as the main door swung open, revealing the church to the elements. Slow but deliberate footsteps pierced the air, getting closer and closer. "Get in here," Maddie whispered. Billy's face dropped. "Come on," she pleaded. "We have no choice. He'll find us." Maddie helped Billy in. Shuffling him over, she climbed in beside him. It was cramped and cold, but so close together they could warm each other.
Good, good. All right, so there's a word that I want to go over with you, and then a phrase that has a lot of adverbs and adjectives in it that I want to practice, okay? This word is close and also close, all right? Mm-hmm. Now, they're spelled the same, all right? Okay, close and close, all right? So when we close with a Z sound, I'm closing the door, okay? Mm-hmm. That's close, okay? But if me and you are sitting next to each other in the movie theater, okay, me and you, Inga, we are close, okay? So that is in distance, okay? We're close. We're right next to each other, okay? Now, in this reading, okay, you see the word, we're on the third line, so it says getting. Now, is that going to be closer or closer? Are they talking about distance, or are they talking about the verb in closing something? What do you think, Inga?
We are talking about that we are close, like in theater.
Exactly. So like in the theater, okay? So here, instead of saying closer, okay, now, and the trick here is whenever you see an ER at the end, so an ER and EST, that is going to be close, closer, closest, okay? When you see an ED or ING, that's going to be closed, so the verb, closing the door, or the door was closed when I got here. Okay, so one is a verb, okay, and one is what? Going to be a preposition because we would use it in a preposition, okay? Or it would be an adverb describing how or the distance we are, okay, from each other, right? So that's gonna be your trigger. You see, if you see an ER or an EST at the end of it, that's gonna be an S sound. All right. Okay. If it's an ED or ING, then you're going to be that's going to be the verb. That's that Z sound. Okay. Mm-hmm. Other than that, if you just see C L O S E, okay, you have to look at the contents around it. Okay? If it says something like sitting, if it has a verb right in front of it, like getting, okay? So getting closer, okay? Or we're sitting close, all right? That's going to be that S sound. But if we say, I got up to, and then to close, all right? And you're using that in the infinitive form, all right? That's when we're going to pronounce that Z sound, all right? It's a confusing word, but there are certain triggers that you can look at to be able to pronounce it correctly, okay?
Okay.
The next one I want to practice with you is that first sentence. This is a doozy. Okay? So, starting off with a loud bang. I'm going to read through that, and I want you to copy how I say things, okay? This is a loud bang intensified. Whistling shattered the silence as the main door swung open, revealing the church to the elements. Okay, try that.
A loud bang and intensified whistling shattered the silence as the main door swung open, revealing the church to the elements.
All right, sorry, I had that my verbling thing come open. Okay, the next word is deliberate.
Deliberate.
Okay, so at that end where we have the A-T-E, instead of saying deliberate, we say deliberate. Deliberate.
Deliberate.
Good, good. Okay. Other than that, excellent job. Your ED endings were sounding fabulous. All right. And everything else was really good. Just remember about that word close. It's a confusing one. Okay. All right, you guys. Great job. Excellent practices today on our pronunciation. I hope you have your notebook with you and you are taking notes on words that you can practice on. Okay. All right, you guys. My next hour is going to be I can't remember. I had to close down my next thing. I had to close down my thing. I have to reopen it again. What did I
say? Grammar.
We're going to be going over vocabulary. So yesterday we asked a lot of questions about law and order and whatnot. We're going to be going over vocabulary, practicing those words and whatnot. Then after that, I have my grammar class. Good. All right, I'm glad you guys know what I'm teaching.
Okay, bye, Charles.
Bye, you guys.
Bye,
see you.
Bye. See you later.
Have a nice
Thank
day.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.